If you know you are going to be free, where are you?
To ba mo pe wa di omi ara lai ni bolo wa.
Father, in Jesus name.
Papa ni oruko Jesu.
We thank you for this night.
Adupe lowo yin fun asale yin.
The yoke breaking night.
Asale jija jaga.
Lord, we know you are here.
Oluwa mo pe wa ni.
You are here, your power.
E wa ni pelu agbara.
You are here, your authority.
E wa ni pelu ase.
Lord Jesus will welcome you.
Oluwa Jesu a kin kaabo.
You will save. You will heal. You will deliver. You will set free. Lord, we pray tonight.
Will
be the night of salvation for everyone. Night of healing for everyone. Night of deliverance for everyone. Nobody will miss your miracle power.
Come
into every life tonight, Lord. Thank you because we know it is done. In Jesus' name we pray. God bless you. You can sit down. Tonight, as we come to this yoke breaking crusade, knowing and understanding that Christ is here, that God Almighty is here, that Holy Ghost is here, to break every yoke in your life. I'm reading the scriptures to you from Luke chapter 4 verse 18.
Luke chapter 4 verse 18.
It says the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the broken hearted and to deliver to the captives, and the recovering of sight to the blind, and to set at liberty them that are bruised, and to preach and to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. And now in verse 21, and he began to say unto them, this day is this scripture fulfilled in your ears. There's a fulfillment in your life tonight. A confirmation in your life tonight. What I have read to you came from the mouth of Jesus Christ. He introduced himself unto them as he's introduced himself to you tonight. And he declared unto them, proclaimed unto them why he came, what he came to do, and what he was going to accomplish. The same Jesus is here tonight. We told of Jesus the same yesterday and today and forever. The same thing he said at that time, he said to you today. He's still telling us, he's still telling you. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. And he says the Lord has anointed him to proclaim the good news to you. Good news for the poor. Good news for the oppressed. Good news for the people who are suffering. Good news for those in darkness. Good news for those who are tormented. Your own good news has come tonight. It's coming to you. And you so stretch forth your hand of faith. And you receive that good news. Goodness in a higher level will start in your life tonight. The goodness of Christ and the goodness of heaven is entering your house today. That's why Jesus said, he sent me to proclaim the good news to the poor. He said, he has sent me. And what he sent him to do is going to accomplish in your life. He says, it is to heal the broken hearted. If your heart is broken, your family is broken, your business is broken, everything in your life broken, There is a healing tonight. I said there's a healing tonight. Healing is coming to you. I will receive. Where are you? You will receive in Jesus' name. And then he speaks about deliverance of the captives. Those who are captives of Satan, captives of evil spirits, deliverance has come. Freedom. Vibration. It has come to you tonight. And the recovering of sight to the blind. Blind eyes will open here tonight. Those who are lame will rise up and walk tonight. And those who have long-standing mountains of problems. All those problems are removed tonight. Once again, I'm happy to tell you that you're free. I said you're free. Tonight I bring the message of hope to you. Total deliverance through Christ our Savior. Total deliverance through Christ our Savior. I'm going to divide to three simple parts. Number one, freedom declaration by the Savior. Freedom declaration. Declaration by the Savior. The Lord came to inform you tonight that every problem you have carried by yourself until this time, and
I've
been following you like a wagon. Tonight, the yoke is broken. Freedom declaration by the Savior. Number two, full deliverance for every soul. It's not a partial deliverance tonight. Those far at the back, and those who are on the sides, and of course those in front of me here, full deliverance. Full deliverance for every soul, that means for everyone. Number three, firm decision for total salvation. As for God, he is ready. As for Christ, he wants to bless you. As for power, there's power here tonight. As for salvation, salvation is available. As for healing and miracle, it's available in multiplied folds. The key is in your hand. That's why you are called to a decision. Firm decision for total salvation. You will decide for a better life tonight. You will decide for total freedom tonight. You will decide for your miracle and blessing tonight. You will not be a man of indecision. You will not be a woman of indecision. You will decide. Are you there? Where are you? Are you a man of decision? A woman of decision? Once you make that decision, firm, steadfast, unchanging, total salvation will enter your life. Three things. Number one, freedom declaration by the Savior. This is coming to you as if there's nobody else. As if you're the only one there. And he's saying that he brings salvation to you. He brings freedom to you. And he stands in your presence. He stands in front of you. And he declares your freedom. Look at that in verse 18 again. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. That Spirit is still active today. Working miracles today. Setting free the captives today. And giving us total freedom today. And as you know that this is for you. It says, because he has anointed me to proclaim the good news to the poor. You don't have to be thinking, what will I pay? This one money cannot buy. This is freedom. Freedom from sin. Freedom from sickness. Freedom from suffering. Freedom from satanic affliction. You don't have to pay any money at all. That's why Jesus came to this world. And he died for you on the cross of Calvary. He has paid the whole price. Not even a grain of sand is needed to add to that sacrifice. Not a single cobble is needed to add to that price he paid. A glass of water, a bottle of water is not crazy to add to what he has paid. A little spoon of oil is not necessary to add to that sacrifice. A little light from the candle, we don't need to add to that sacrifice. He said he has paid the whole price. And now he comes to declare your freedom. Thank God you are free. All those things that bound you, that you wanted to be free, and you cannot be free. I try. I struggle. I don't want to do this. I don't want to do that. But there's no power in man to overcome sin. Christ has come to set you free. Those things that brought your back to the ground, that made you to fall, and you have been saying, who will deliver me? Your Savior has come to you tonight. Your deliverer has come to you tonight.
Then
he said, he has sent me to heal the brokenhearted. What is it that has brought sorrow in your heart? Your heart is broken. There's no joy. There's no happiness. You go about what you head about. And it's like everything is finished. Maybe you have even considered committing suicide. That it is better to die than to come to open shame. But tonight, your freedom has come. All those things that made you to be sorrowful, all the problems that made you to want to die, the Lord is saying tonight that the Father has sent him to heal the brokenhearted, and to give deliverance to the captives. They tied you down like they tied goats. They tie you down and they say you cannot make progress. Now deliverance has come. I see Jesus by your side here. And he's already untying your rope. He's already removing all those knots. He's already breaking all the yokes. And the prison doors are now open. The light is shining to you right now.
You've
come out of that dungeon of darkness. You will come out of that oppression. And then he says, he's giving the covering of sight to the blind. Glaucoma will vanish away. Cataract will vanish away. All those dead nerves in your eyes that make you not to see. Or you have been seeing double. Everything will be clear tonight. Christ the healer is here. Christ the Christ the Savior is here. And he has declared your freedom.
And he
says it to set at liberty them that are bruised. Liberty. Liberation. Total freedom. It's just tonight. I said it's yours tonight. How will you have that? John chapter 8. Reading from verse 32. John chapter 8 verse 32. And ye shall know the truth. And ye shall know the truth. And the truth shall make you free. And that's what I've been telling you. What I've been telling you is the truth you need to know. When he said he shall know the truth, he could have said he shall know the gospel. He could have said he shall know the good news. He could have said he shall hear the freedom declaration. At the moment you know the truth, and you hear that good news, and you hear that gospel, and you hear of your freedom declaration, that moment you are free. That's why you're going to make up your mind tonight. I have heard the truth. I have believed the truth. And since I know the truth, I accept the truth that Jesus is my Savior, that Jesus is my healer, that Jesus is my deliverer. I believe it in my heart. I confess it with my mouth. There is no doubt in my heart. Jesus came to this world to die for me. He came to forgive my sin. Once you know that truth, he came to heal my sicknesses. He came to destroy the works of the devil. Once you know that truth, you accept that truth. Do you believe? I said, do you believe? Do you accept that what Jesus said is for you? I'm asking you a question. Do you accept that what Jesus did and said that is for you? Do you believe? Do you accept? It's yours. Ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Freedom declaration by the Savior. The one who has declared your freedom is a person that cannot lie. And he has power to fulfill his promise. That power will work in your life tonight. When the power works, what are you going to have? That is the point number two. Full deliverance for every soul. Total deliverance. Complete deliverance. All over, all around. Deliverance. In your spirit tonight, there's deliverance. In your soul, there's deliverance. In your body, there's deliverance. Every power that held you down, there's deliverance for you tonight. I can see you coming and giving your testimony tonight. Look at that man is going to give testimony tonight. Look at that woman going to give testimony tonight. Testimony of full deliverance. There was somebody who was crying out because he became dejected. Somebody was crying out because he found he could not help himself. He was crying out because there's nobody to deliver him. Listen, are in Romans chapter 7.
In verse
24.
He
says, "No wretched man that I am." We're not talking about somebody who didn't go to school. We're not talking about somebody who was a bank, who was a kind of backward society. We're not talking about somebody who was not well known. Here is somebody who was well known in society. And if you think about being popular, the man was popular. Think about the man having authority, had authority. But he had bondage in his life. He had captivity in his life. He tried everything he could try. He tried something in the dark. He's tried something of power. He tried something in his own nation. He tried something outside his nation. Yet he could not be free until he cried out, wretched man that I am, who shall deliver me from this body of death? Who shall deliver me? He didn't say, what shall deliver me? If he said what, maybe education can deliver him. Maybe wealth can deliver him. Maybe authority can deliver him. Maybe something can deliver him. Maybe philosophy can deliver him. He had tried everything, yet he was not free. What have you tried so you can be free? Where have you gone so you can be free? What are you struggling about so you can be free? There is no power on earth that can deliver you. There's a power coming from heaven today. There's a power coming from the throne of God today. That power resides in Jesus Christ. And as a man cried and said, "Oh wretched man that I am," he found himself a prisoner in the cage of sin, in the cage of sickness, in the cage of bondage, in the cage of perennial sin and Satan, perpetually oppressing him. Who shall deliver me? Who shall deliver me? When you make it personal, and you're not just thinking, okay, it's going to help them, it's going to touch them, it's going to deliver them, but you know that this is yours. Who shall deliver me from this body of death? In the next verse it said, "I thank God through Jesus Christ our Lord." He discovered the deliverer. He met the deliverer. Tonight you will discover, when you fail before you are going to succeed now. Well, before you are going to rise now, when you have been crying before, joy, laughter will come to you today. You have gone everywhere looking for solution, and there was no solution. You spent money, you took medicine, you tried power, you used long leg, you used long hand, you used everything you could use, but you see the wretched man that could not be delivered. Tonight I welcome you to full deliverance. Tonight full deliverance has come. I thank God through Jesus Christ our Lord. What he's saying there, when he made Jesus Christ his own Lord,
total freedom came. Number one, freedom came from sin. He had said inside the chapter, what I didn't want to do, that's what I do. What I do, I allow not. That's why he cried out, "O wretched man that I am." He said, "Jesus, I cannot help myself. Come and help me." Jesus is coming to help you. I said, "Jesus is coming to help you." He said, "I need help." Somebody there, I need help. Help for salvation. Help for healing. Help for deliverance. That all my yoke will be broken tonight. Welcome to your full deliverance. He'll save you from sin tonight. He'll heal your sick body tonight. He will break the yoke of captivity tonight. I thank God. Tonight, you will thank God. You will praise God. You will sing songs of joy to God. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who is now my Lord. He'll be the captain of your salvation. He will lead you to victory. He will lead you to success. He will lead you to joy. Full deliverance has now come. Let's come back to this. John chapter 8. John chapter 8. Verse 36. If the Son therefore shall make you free, ye shall be free indeed. That Son is the Lord Jesus Christ that is going to be your Lord tonight. He has your freedom in his hand. He has your joy in his hand. He has your salvation in his hand. He has the key in his hand. If you are wise, you will come to the one that has the key of the success of your life. He has the key to the salvation of your life. He has the key to the healing of your body. He has the key to the opening of your prison. Because if the Son therefore shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. Look at that. You shall be free. And then there's another word added to that freedom. Free indeed. That's what makes it full redemption. He will forgive every sin you ever committed since you were born. He will set you free from the power of that sin that bound you. And then all the consequences of sin, suffering here on earth, suffering on the other side of the grave, he will take all that suffering away. Suffering in your body at present, he will take all that suffering away. All the brain problem, he will take all the brain problem away. In short, he will give you full deliverance. And it is for everyone tonight. Point number three. Firm decision for total salvation. Firm decision for total salvation. We're coming back to that. Luke chapter 4. And I'm reading reading from verse 21.
Luke 4:21.
And he began to say unto them, this day is this scripture fulfilled in your ears. Everything you have heard in your ears tonight, this day is the day of fulfillment. You heard about Jesus being the Saviour. This day is the day of fulfillment. You
are
Jesus talking about good news for the poor. This day is the day of fulfillment in your life. You heard about Jesus Christ healing the brokenhearted. This day is the day of your fulfillment. You heard that he came to break every yoke and to destroy the works of the devil. And he set the captives free. All those who are in captivity of sickness, legs are tied, you cannot walk. This day, you rise up and walk. The bandage of the devil has closed your eyes, you cannot see. This day is a day of recovering of sight. Those who are bruised, you wake up in the morning and then you see marks all over your body. The marks that were not there before you slept last night, and they bruise you every night. All those evil powers that come to bruise your life and your body, deliverance has come for you tonight. This day is this scripture fulfilled in your ears. Look at verse 32 there. And they were astonished at his doctrine, for his word was with power. All those things that he said they will do. Freedom, the declaration, it entered into their lives with power. Full deliverance, it entered into their life with power. And it is when you take that decision, firm decision, I receive Jesus as my Savior tonight, I make him my Lord tonight, I decide tonight, it is not a shaking decision. It is not a wobbling decision. It is a firm decision. Tonight, he is my Savior. I abandon every other source of help. All the things I've been running after, and I could not have total deliverance, I abandoned them tonight. Jesus is enough for me. He is sufficient for me. Sufficient for my salvation. Sufficient for my healing. Sufficient for my deliverance. His word was with power. Look at verse 36. And they were all amazed and spake among themselves, saying, what a word is this? For with authority and power he commanded unclean spirits, and they come out. The moment you take that firm decision, I believe Jesus tonight, I receive Jesus tonight, I come to Jesus tonight, I make him my Lord tonight, I make him my Savior tonight, and he's sufficient for me. I will not go to paths of darkness anymore. I will not be walking around in the wilderness of the world anymore. Today I come to Christ, never to turn back again. Authority will come into your life. Power will come into your life. The moment you decide,
I
say, I make up my mind today. I receive Jesus as my Savior. Nothing will turn me back. Nothing will stop me. Are you making up your mind right now? I said, are you making up your mind right now? I want to tell you that your time of total deliverance has now come. Heaven is ready for you. God is ready for you. That same Jesus that saved many people in the past is ready for you tonight. The healing is waiting for you tonight. His deliverance is waiting for you tonight. Whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. You are that whosoever. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that you, whosoever believes in him, will not perish. Congratulations, I come to declare to you tonight, you will not perish. You will not perish. As you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ tonight, but you will have everlasting life. God is ready for you. Are you ready for him? Where are you? I said, are you ready for him? Where are you over there? I said, are you ready for heaven? Where are you there? Are you ready for salvation? Are you ready for blessing? Are you ready for the good news? Are you ready to make him your Lord and Savior tonight? He's looking for you. What are you? Tell him, oh Lord, Lord Jesus, I come to you tonight. I have heard the good news that you will forgive my sin. I have heard the good news that you will save my soul. I decide. Nobody else is deciding with me. I decide. I'm not looking at any other person. I decide. I'm not waiting for another person. I decide that I come to you tonight. Personally. Voluntarily. Deliberately. I want you, Jesus, my Lord and Savior tonight. It's my personal decision. Your body will tamper with this decision. Jesus, I stand up. I raise up my hand. I identify myself. You are my Savior tonight. I have decided. No turning back. No turning back. No turning back. I'm not allowing anybody to dissuade me. No turning back. A firm decision. Your salvation has come. You're standing up. I said your salvation has come. You raised up your hand and you're standing up for Christ. Your salvation has come. All your sins will be forgiven. Salvation from heaven is recorded around concerning your name today. Jesus says, as you receive him, you are saved. You are saved. Say amen. Say I accept. Say I believe. Keep on standing. Let's confirm your decision now in prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for every man, every woman, every boy, every girl that raised up a hand, standing up, making a decision to abandon their sin, to abandon darkness, and to come to Christ as Savior. As each one of them receives Jesus as Lord and Savior right now. In your grace, in your love, in your mercy, forgive all their sins in Jesus' name. Take condemnation away from them. Bring freedom unto them. Let new life come unto them right now. Bear witness in their hearts that whosoever comes to you, you will not reject. Assure every one of them right now, you have accepted them. You have saved them. And now new life has come to them. We thank you for your mercy and love. Thank you for your grace upon them. Thank you for the salvation they have got now. Firm decision that they have made. Affirm your blessing of salvation. In Jesus' name we pray. Miracle has come. Let's pray now. Father, we thank you tonight. We glorify your name tonight. Tonight is the night of breaking you. And by the anointing, every yoke will be broken. I send for that authority and anointing upon every life tonight. Your yokes are broken in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray every swelling in anyone there, greater announcement, and whatever swelling may be there, I command now come out in Jesus' name. I pray for those who have insanity madness. That evil spirit, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray you set them free. Epilepsy, you are free in Jesus' name. I pray for those who have an incurable disease, internal disease inside their body, cancer, ulcer, tuberculosis, asthma, whatever the problem, be healed in Jesus' name. I pray for those who are deaf and dumb. I pray sound will enter your ears right now. Your vocal cords will be active now in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who are blind. Whatever is causing the blindness, cataract, come out. Glaucoma, come out. Total blindness be healed in Jesus' name. I pray the light of Christ will shine in your eyes. As you open your eyes, you'll see clearly in Jesus' name. I pray for some stroke. I pray that strength will come into your muscles. Those who are paralyzed, power will come into your joints. Rise up and walk in Jesus' name. I pray for those who have arthritis. All the pains will go away in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who have that terrible problem of cancer. Cancer, dry up right now. Be healed right now. I pray for those who have life-threatening disease. That you think you are going to die, You will not die. Life has come. Receive your miracle in Jesus' name. HIV AIDS, you are healed. HIV, come out in Jesus' name. There's some evil spirits tormenting them. Powers of darkness tormenting them. That yoke is broken in your life. You are free. Receive your deliverance in Jesus' name. Lord, miracle everywhere. To the right, to the left, to the center, to the back, miracle everywhere. Everyone, miracle everywhere. Deliverance everywhere. Healing everywhere. Lord, open those windows of heaven. Confirmation on everyone. Confirmation on everyone. Confirmation of miracle for everyone. It is done. It is done. We thank you, Lord. As we open our eyes, we're going to see many, many, many miracles. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. It has happened. It has happened. It has happened. Check up yourself, your miracle is there.